Hey, it's me, Destin. Welcome back to Smarter Every Day. So in one of the last episodes, I introduced you to a legend with a longbow. He's from my hometown, and his name is Byron Ferguson. He shot an aspirin out of the air in slow motion. But there's something that happened in the arrow I didn't understand. It was deflecting, and this has something to do with what's called the archer's paradox. What do you think, Byron?
Archer's paradox is the demon for all archers, but there are ways to work around it.
Not bad. All right, so today on Smarter Every Day, we're gonna understand how an arrow deflects in what's called the archer's paradox. A paradox is a situation involving two things with a contradictory nature. So what is the archer's paradox? What are the two things that an archer has to deconflict? My friend John explained it to me like this. Let's pretend that this pecan tree is the bow and this is the line of our bowstring. If we take an arrow and we put it into our bow and we draw the bow back and we're trying to hit that target over there, watch what happens. As we release the bowstring and it travels closer to the bow, look at that. The fact that the bow is sitting here in our way between us and the target causes the arrow to point off in a different direction. So how can we possibly hit that target when our arrow is pointed over there? This is the archer's paradox, because we know they actually do hit targets like that. Toy designers are cheaters. They don't deal with the paradox, they just get around it. For example, the guy who designed this suction cup bow, he doesn't go around the handle, straight through the middle. Check that out. Whoever designed this crossbow, instead of being in line with the bow itself, the string is offset by this big rail. That way the string is always pushing along the dart. So how does a longbow shooter get around this problem? Here's how. They don't have a completely rigid arrow like that. They have a bendable arrow like this. See, when it vibrates, you can see these nodal points? That's important. Check this out. As we put this real arrow into the bow here, and we shoot, as we go towards the bow, the fact that we're accelerating this arrow causes it to build up strain energy, causing this big curvature. That curvature then snaps back in the other direction once it bends to a certain point, and look what we have. We have the arrow bending around the bow. When we release, it does something cool. It snakes around the bow just like this, and you're able to fly all the way to the target. So the archer's paradox is the fact that you have a bow in between you and the target, and you're still able to get around the bow.
The first thing that happens is the arrow bends from the pressure of the string and the front of the arrow being against the riser of the bow. As it leaves the bow, and it's already clear of the bow, it bends in the opposite direction. Where those two cross determines where the arrow will fly. 100% of the time, the arrow will fly to where these two points are crossed or pointed. In other words, if this one had been here, then the arrow's gonna fly off to the left. If it was here, the arrow will fly off to the right. We want those two lined up to go straight to the target.
Gotcha, so the fact that it bends helps it get around the arrow rest mm-hmm. without going off at an angle, as if it
right.
were a straight line.
Correct.
You're pushing the string straight towards the handle, but somehow it makes it around the handle.
Right.
And the bends are how it does that.
That's correct.
All right, my buddy Xander actually shoots with a compound bow. You don't do any of that longbow stuff, right?
I have one, but I'm not really good at it.
All right, so what's the deal here?
So compound, there's a whole lot more going on a compound. It means there's more things that can go wrong too, but there are several advantages if they're working.
Yeah.
So the compound, you see that it's cut out in the middle. You got this.
Oh, so the riser's notched out is what you're saying?
Yeah, so the arrow is traveling straight. It doesn't have to go around a riser.
Okay.
And many people shoot also a drop away rest. You see the arrow's kind of dropped down. Whenever you pull the bow back, a string attached to one of the bow strings pulls the rest up.
Nice.
Centers your arrow. If you have it all lined up and square, your arrow's nice and level. And then when you shoot, that arrow will drop, the rest will drop
away. Well, shoot it. Let's do it. Hold on, wait. Let me zoom in.
All right.
Hold on, so I'm looking at that rest, it's gonna fall away, right?
That's real fast.
Okay, I'm ready. Dude, that is super fast. So is the arrow touching the rest as it goes through
it? A little bit.
Really?
Because it drops, but it's not, immediate. It's down before the full arrow passes it.
So the goal here is you don't have to bend around the riser, but I bet the arrow still bends though.
It does bend, and that's actually important in the straightness of the arrow flight.
Isn't that interesting? But something else is going on here. Byron Ferguson is able to predict the wobbling of that arrow so good that he's able to hit an aspirin tablet with a vibrating arrow just like that. So one of two things is going on. Either A, he knows some science that we don't, or B, he
He's a warlock and this is all black magic.
Okay, the stiffness of an arrow is called the spine, right? And so the spine is what, Byron?
The stiffness of the arrow.
All right. So this is your spine tester?
This is the spine tester. It's set up right now to test the deflection of a carbon arrow.
Okay.
So we're actually have a 2-pound weight, and the arrow suspended 26 inches. That's for carbon.
Okay.
And we'll read the inside of the scale here to see how much it deflects.
So you test all of your arrows before you shoot so that you can normalize the paradox.
Correct. I want all the arrows to have the same stiffness.
And that's how you're able to hit things like an aspirin.
That's part of it, yes.
That's part, right. Part. There's a little bit of skill. If it's out of tolerance, you just don't even put it in your quiver.
That's what those are.
Really? Really? You just got a box of stuff that you don't shoot?
Yeah, they're too far out of tolerance.
Really? That's amazing. So people were asking in the last video, that arrow was deflecting so much, they're saying, how do you time that? And the way you time that is you know the exact spine of the arrow.
Correct.
That's awesome. That's pretty good information. So this isn't black magic, this is science.
Correct.
That's awesome.
Byron is using science to normalize the wobble of his arrows. But let's admit, there's a little bit of wizardry here, right? Because at a certain distance from his bow, he still has to know which side of the arrow that wobble is going to be on. And then he has to line that up with an aspirin tablet. So this is a pretty good shot. In order to fully appreciate this trick shot, I'm going to do a trick shot of my own using the Phantom Miro. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Smarter Every Day. It was sponsored by Harry's.com. Harry's makes subscription razors that are really high quality. They end up being about the same price as the old razors I used to use. So I have no need for my old razors. So Byron's gonna help me get rid of it. If you're interested in getting a Harry's razor, I actually shaved with one today. Go to Harry's.com and use the promo code SMARTER. Where are you gonna try?
We're gonna try to hit it down in here. Around the neck part.
Get rid of it that way?
Cut its head off.
Excellent. All right, I'm gonna film this with the Phantom V711. I hope you hit it, this'll be awesome. You did it! Like I thought you would do it, but you did it. That was the first shot, Byron.
Lucky.
Whatever, man. All right, there you go. So if you want to support Smarter Every Day, go to harrys.com, use the promo code SMARTER, get you a discount on some razors. Thank you for supporting Smarter Every Day. Please consider subscribing, and thank you as always, Byron.
Can I get some Harry razors too?
You can. I'm Destin, you're getting smarter every day. Have a good one. He actually hit that. You make your own arrowheads, right?
No, I designed the head. It's actually made in Austria. This is what's called a destructive test.
Holy cow, it didn't break, man. It didn't break. It didn't break.
That is cool.
Did you think it would do that?
I was hoping.